for the people who live in Qatar to see what their competency in terms of building the information model, in terms of the digital transformation journey that needed in the construction sector. And basically, when you fill this particular form, you not just help us in terms of trying to analyze where we are now and how we wanted to go forward, but you can help yourself as well, because the world is moving towards, particularly if you are into the construction sector, moving fairly rapidly in terms of the building information modeling culture, where information is being passed from a stage to another, backed up by standard processes with the best digital technologies that is available. So the BIM competency is about people from the UK and people from Australia, Bilal Sukkar and Jamiat Qatar here through Dr. Jamal, and we have Omar currently on board as well to help us collecting data. But basically, we are starting this particular work about a year ago, and we wanted to make sure that we exhaust all the questionnaire, and we fill the questionnaire in order to have a proper and better analysis. So this is where we are. I'm from Teesside University. My name is Professor Daywood, and Dr. Qasim from Northumbria, and we have both Dr. Sukkar and Dr. Jamal leading this particular work. So basically, what it's all about is to improve the build performance of industry production across Qatar through benchmarking, and empower clients and employers to pre-qualify the build competency for project participants. So basically, as we see the revolution started somewhere else around the world in terms of the building information modeling, there is an issue related to whether the people capital is ready, what is needed, and then when the project starts, they need to benchmark your performance. You benchmark your whether you have a degree, whether you have practices, and so therefore you can fit in this new revolution. Now, it is quite exciting, quite interesting, because at the moment there isn't any course. Let's say you have civil engineering courses, building courses. If there's any course that is building information modeling, it's cutting across a number of engineering courses, and we need to see whether this is going to be a profession in some light, in terms of building information modeling, or whether it's going to be part of a profession. Being a civil engineer, you have to be in the BIM world if you wanted to manage projects, or in the building sector, if you wanted to manage a project, you've got to be a BIM enabled in order to manage the work. My opinion is that all project managers, design coordinators, project coordinators, is moving towards what we call BIM managers, because this is where you coordinate the processes and you try to fill in the gaps available in terms of both the processes and the digital world. And the other one is obviously to support Qatar education system responding to industry requirements. So part of your survey they're going to fill in, we're going to do the analysis. After the analysis, we identify where the gaps are and what is needed in order to improve these gaps in terms of whether the educational system or the training system. And obviously, if you read literature, if you've been working abroad, particularly countries who've been BIM enabled, there are lots of sort of process has been developed, course has been developed, accreditation has been developed, and that is still lacking here. Okay, moving on. So the benchmark is really to help you, and these are some of the surveys that we put forward. We've got in front of you some of these printed surveys. I hope it won't take them more than 20 minutes. Those of you who are in different sector in the construction industry, they can sort of fill this form starting from zero, which is known to not applicable, and four is the expert, and ask you two questions. For example, keep a model log, doing things to do with the model, using certain model server, How do you use it? So there is the process of being IT enabled, the process being a process enabled, the process. So it does have a wide remit. We have a survey online, but at the moment as you fill it in, we will put it online for you. But if you have friends and other people that you wanted to participate in the survey, so we will have, if you could pass this to them. But basically the benefit for you really is we will try to offer courses to you, because we were asking you about your emails, because as we put the survey, we're going to we're going to put your email, so therefore you can be communicated, and we're going to create a particularly distance learning courses to support people. And believe me, people are paying lots of money to attend some of these courses, particularly in the standards is going to be developed, or standards being developed, and the processes is being developed, and how that will conform with contract strategies, the legal issues, the RCT issues, etc. Okay, so your role is quite crucial, because you know, unless we know where we are in terms of Qatar, it's difficult to start the journey. It's difficult to recommend to Qatar University or to recommend to other providers what is needed, what are the gaps, and how we're going to move forward. So basically, this is where we are, and myself, Omar, and Dr. Jamal is around. If you have any questions that you wanted to get some help in terms of the survey, and once you finish the survey, could you please write your name, your email, a preferable company email, and if you have other people that might be able to pass it on, to pass the survey. I'm happy to answer questions, happy to go around and discuss things with you. Thank you.